Home is where the heart is, or so the saying goes. In Levan Akin's award-winning 2019 film And Then We Danced, as in his compassionate latest film Crossing, it's a little more complicated than that. Moments of respite at home are few and far between for Akin's characters. When they do come, his camera lingers on them, holding on to the passing instants when his protagonists can let their guard down. Those momentary glimpses of harmony are precious. For Akin's characters, being at home is more often than not an ordeal. It's no surprise then that they are often tempted to leave these largely unquiet homes and look for peace and acceptance elsewhere. Stepping outside, they enter public spaces, and there they face the world.
Leamas. Kaikhvitsit. Nakhe chamovodi Istanbulshi. Kaikhedet.
Going out is a chance to observe new horizons. But the people to be found there are more important to Akin than the sights. So often, in an unfamiliar city, we are among people who know nothing of our past. In Crossing, the protagonists Lia and Achi are brought together in their search for Lia's missing niece, Tekla.
No, Tekla.
The city of Istanbul, far away from Georgia, plays host to their unlikely friendship. Akin's characters are eager to immerse themselves into the hustle and bustle. What makes public spaces so enticing to him and his characters is the thought of disappearing in an anonymous crowd. This is true for the young transgender woman, Tekla, in Crossing, who has left rural Georgia for Istanbul to escape its orthodox gender norms.
She's in Istanbul, is Kalak here, so that's Halki Chamodista, which is nerd.
But even Tekla's aunt, Lia, is seduced. For the older woman, being in this particular city allows her to come out of her shell. Flattered by the hospitality of a local Georgian expat, Lia drinks and flirts with this stranger, something she would never do back home. Akin highlights the sometimes whiplash-inducing contrast between different spaces and their opposing rules in And Then We Danced. At the studio where Mehrab rehearses, he must pay extreme attention to his technique. But conventions are abandoned when he is out of class and in the world. He is able to embrace his sexuality, and his body is freed from the rules of the dance studio in the differently lit spaces of nightclubs. Later, Mehrab combines his experience of both spaces, the public and the private, into his modern interpretation of traditional Georgian dance. Moving from one space into another can be difficult, and Akin is especially sensitive to the processes of interrogation that take place at their borders. People are assessed and scrutinized, as if to ask, who are you really? Are you authorized to enter here? Can you be a part of this?
So where are you from?
Batumi.
Ah, Komşu.
Ah, Kavkazes.
Gürcistan, yes,
Gürcistan, Komşu, neighbor.
To exist in certain spaces with other people, then, is often to perform. Akin is awake to the fact that only a lucky few get to act natural, with desires and appearances that more easily conform to the mainstream, they can almost forget the boundary between private and public. Others cannot fully relax. They cannot safely be themselves. When they try to, these tend to be stolen, secret moments, often taken at great risk. In And Then We Danced, Akin's camera collects each of the knowing looks shared between Merab and the new dancer, Irakli, as if they were small treasures. But for some, the fear of being found out comes with the excitement of transgression.
Adımı merak etmiyor musun? Yani polis falan çevirir ve yani arkadaş olmadığımızı anlar diye söylüyorum.
Evrim, a transgender lawyer in Crossing, navigates public spaces with assertiveness, imposing new meaning upon them. The taxi is a place to have a one-night stand. The office is a haven for those who support her ambitions. And the city itself is where she feels most comfortable as she walks the streets as her own person. Across these two films, Akin portrays public space as liminal. Anonymous though it is to begin with, it is also where some connections are first made, where the seeds of intimacy are first sown. Ultimately, space is always in dialogue with Akin's characters. Their vulnerability, their repression, their dualities, their ecstasies. Space can contract, but also expand, to include the new, the risky, the unknown. Until the unfamiliar, too, becomes familiar and welcoming. A space more accepting than the home they know, it's also where a new home may one day be found.